why Boni Kapoor didn't launch Daughter Janvi. The recently released Millie, her fifth after Dhadak, Gunjan Saxena, Ruhi and Good Luck Cherry, was Janvi Kapoor's first film with dad Boni. In the past, Boni has worked hard to design the launch of his brothers Anil Kapoor in Woh Saath Din and Sanjay Kapoor in Prem. And he produced the debut film of a star kid like Isha Deol in Koi Mere Dil Se Poochhe. Considering he's still an active producer juggling with films in Hindi, Tamil and Telugu, what stopped Boni from giving Janvi a grand debut? In a short conversation with me, Janvi revealed why Karan Johar launched her and not dad Boni. I'm Bharti S. Pradhan and here's my conversation with Janvi. How is it, this is your first film with your dad as producer. How is it that he never launched you and Karan launched you?
I think it was a decision that both of us took. I think it would put too much pressure on me for me, to live up to being launched in my dad's film. And I think it would put a lot of pressure on him to launch me and make sure. I think it would have been a lot of emotional pressure more than anything else. And also, I mean, people assume that being launched by Karan and Dharma was as good as being launched by a home production, but it isn't the same thing. I did have my process with that as well.
As in
I had to audition for that as well. I just, like I said, I had my foot in the door and I can't deny my privilege, but I can't be apologetic about it either. And I can't give people the narrative that they want to believe, which is that, oh, maybe mom called him up and like it just happened. That's not what happened either at all.
So how did that happen? Who approached whom actually?
I met Karan at a party and I went up to him and I spoke to him. And then I think he came home to meet my mom and he said, let her come and read with me. And so I did a series of, I think, 5-6 readings with him where he would print out different scenes for me every day and I'd essentially audition. We didn't really know which film it was for.
Okay.
He was just seeing if I was even an option he'd want to consider to be a part of the company at all. There was no film.
Okay.
So I did a series of auditions with him and he didn't really say anything for a long time. And then he said, okay, I want you to audition for something with Shashank. So I did a series of auditions with Shashank. And then that's when
that happened. Okay. So it hasn't been a cakewalk actually. It's not like you just walked into a film.
No. It wasn't like that.
Have you ever told a filmmaker you'd like to work with him?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Many times. I've called up so many people and I've begged for meetings and I've shown up and I've auditioned and I've stalked Nitesh sir for Bawal.
Okay.
I stalked Sajid sir to get that film.
Okay.
Even with Karan, so many times if I hear that there's a film that Dharma's making, it's not a given that I'm going to be in it. I need to speak to the director. I need to speak to Karan. I need to show up for an audition if it requires it. I need to try. Everyone needs to try. I just had my foot in the door. People were just aware about me. I just had the luxury not to wait in line in a queue outside Aramnagar to get an audition, but I still had to audition. And I'm intrinsically aware of my privilege, but that doesn't mean that I'm entitled.
Like Khushi, she's got her foot in the door, but now it's up to her.
Yes, and she also had to audition.
Mm.
Now, maybe our definition of auditioning is different from the quintessential definition of auditioning. I think that unless you prove yourself with your work, the audience has no reason to accept you. And our journey in life has been to, or our goal in life is to try to prove ourselves.
So here we are with what we've understood from Janvi. Lineage alone cannot serve anybody stardom on a platter.